Today we are looking at different coin prices for the 1945 wheat penny. So there's different types of errors to look for on these coins and of course different coin prices based on the condition of these pennies. So welcome back to Couch Collectibles. Hope you guys are having an awesome day. Let's just hop right into it. Start off first here with the 1945 wheat cent. Alright, now the only reason that this coin is going to be valuable is because it has a high grade of a Mint State 67 Plus and it has that red grade. So I've done, you know, videos on red pennies versus brown pennies. Feel free to check that out on the channel. Now this coin here sold for over $4,000. So it's valuable because the coin grading scale only goes up to 70. 70 meaning that it is in perfect condition, and this is at a 67 plus and it's got that red grade. So $4,000. Moving on to a 1945 wheat penny that was broad struck. Now this coin here sold for around $40, so nothing really too valuable, but still an awesome error. You can always look for broad strikes on all kinds of different coins out there. $40. Speaking of broad strikes, here is another wheat penny from 1945 that was broad struck out of collar. Now this coin here sold for around $70, so a little bit more than that $40. So again, always be on the lookout for broad strikes. This coin, personally, not really worth grading in my opinion, but almost $70. Now here is another mint error coin. Now this penny here has been broad struck with an obverse brockage. So we got a brockage there on the front of the coin, the obverse of the coin. Now this coin here is gonna be worth a little bit more money. This penny here sold for over $160 as a result of that mint error. Now here is another mint error that you could look for on other coins. It is a clipped planchet. However, this is a ragged clipped planchet. So you see how it's not, you know, a clean clip there. It's got that ragged edge. That is a ragged clip planchet there. And it's been broad struck as well. Now this wheat penny here sold for around $65. Next up is going to be a 1945 D mint mark, and it's got a clipped planchet as well. You see that clean clip there on the left side of the coin. This penny here, as a result of that and because of its condition, that Mint State 66 red grade, this wheat penny sold for around $90. Next up is a 1945 D. Now this is the same as the first coin. You know, the high grade is what's going to give it all of its value. Mint State 68 red. So there's probably not many of them out there at this grade or higher. That's why the penny sold for over $14,000. Could you imagine selling a penny for $14,000? Now keep in mind, if you have a 1945, no mint mark, D mint mark, S mint mark, and they're all scratched up and beat up and they're circulated and they're not a high grade or they don't have any types of errors, then they're only gonna be worth, you know, a cent or two. Now here's how many they made for the D mint mark. Over 266 million of those coins, so they're not valuable or rare in terms of how many they actually produced. Now this next coin here is very cool. It's a 1945 that has been double struck and flip over in color. All right, so this is pretty cool. So we have the reverse design here. You can see the wheat stocks from the reverse of this wheat cent, 1945 penny, here on the front of the coin. You can actually see the word 1 cent, the lettering here from the reverse as well. Very, very cool type of error. Now you can look for all kinds of different double strikes out there on different dates, on different coins. Now here on the reverse of this penny, you see the date, you see the obverse design coming here on the reverse. So you see the outline of Lincoln's head and you actually see the date 1945 very, very well. That is amazing. Would love to have something like this in my collection. This coin sold for nearly $400. Can't beat that. Now here's another example of that, a different example, double struck, flip over a collar. So we see that wheat stock here on the right side of this wheat penny, and then we see the E there going on the back shoulder of Lincoln. Wow, that is pretty cool. And then here on the reverse, we don't really see much of the date on this one, but you do see the lettering from the obverse, and then you do see some of the outline of Lincoln there. Very, very awesome. This coin sold for over $675. Now here's a 1945 wheat penny that has an elliptical clip. It only weighs 2.24 grams. Of course, these pennies are supposed to weigh 3.1. You can see the design of the Lincoln cent being cut off there. the word liberty and the phrase "In God we trust," the motto. And then here on the reverse, we see that happening as well. Now, this coin here sold for around $90. Next up is a 1945 wee penny that was struck 30% off center. Of course, off centers are taking place on all kinds of different coins, not just pennies. So you can look for all kinds of different off centers on all kinds of different coins. In this case, this coin is graded at a Mint State 62 red brown. And because of that, this penny sold for over $140. Moving on to another off-center. Now, this coin was struck 15% off-center. It is the 1945 D Mint Mark. And this coin here sold for over $260. Can't beat that. Now, this next coin is very, very interesting. It's a 1945 wee penny that was actually struck on the wrong planchet. It was struck on a Netherlands East Indies half-cent planchet. So, wow, look at that. That is pretty insane. We see that it's been worn down, circulated. People just pass this up, never thought anything about it. However, it was actually a valuable mint error. Man, I wish it was in much better condition. This coin sold for over $430. Now, I'm going to show you another example here with this coin. This coin graded by NGC. Same thing, struck on a Northeast Indies half-cent planchet. It only weighs 2.3 grams. And it is graded at a Mint State 64 brown. Now, here's an example of what that Netherlands half-cent coin looks like. This is the planchet that the Lincoln cent design was actually struck on. Now, of course, it wouldn't have the Netherlands design on it. It would just be the blank planchet that it was actually struck on. So this penny here sold for over $900 as a result of that mint error. Now, here's another Lincoln cent design from 1941 to 1945 that was overstruck on a Netherlands East Indies coin. But wow, look at this. This is actually overstruck, so it has the design of the Netherlands coin, which is absolutely amazing, and the design of the Lincoln cent. Wow, this is a super valuable coin here. This coin sold for over $7,000. Woo, $7,000. All right, now here's a 1945 S Mint Mark. Now, this coin was struck 5% off center. This coin sold for around $50 as a result of that mint error. But if we move on here to the S Mint Mark that does not have any type of mint errors, it just has that high grade of a Mint State 67 red. I don't mean just a Mint State 67 red. I mean, it is very rare to have a Mint State 67, 68 on up for these coins. So 1945 S with that high grade sold for over $140. Now, even if it was a Mint State 66, it could change the value drastically. It could be, I'm not sure of the value, I'd have to look at the chart, but it could only be worth $40 or $20. So it really depends on what you think you could get the grade as. If you think you can get a Mint State 68, then it's worth taking the risk in the send. But if it's on the borderline of a Mint State 64, or you think it could be a Mint State 67 or something, that's too large of a gap. In this case, a Mint State 64 is going to be a lot lower price than a Mint State 67 or a Mint State 68. Now, for the S Mint Mark, you also want to look for a repunched Mint Mark. So you can see that there, northeast of the first impression there. Wow, you can see two different S Mint Marks there. So always be on the lookout for that with your coin microscopes, which I have available on couchcollectibles.com. Now, let's check out some other wheat pennies that are worth money. All right, so here's the 1913 D. Now, this is graded at an extra fine 45. You know, typically conditioned coin like this you'd find in pocket change. You know, of course, we're not finding 1913s every day, but if you do go to the bank and search coin rolls, find wheat pennies all the time, mostly just 40s and 50s, but there's times where you can actually find some older pennies like this. Now, this coin did sell for around $50, but if we look at the higher graded version of this coin, graded at a Mint State 66, so red, this coin is a beauty. It is in excellent, excellent condition. And because of that, and because of the high grade, which is the condition of the coin, it sold for over $10,000. So $50 penny versus a $10,000 penny, those are real prices of what these coins have sold for. Now for the 1913, this is the no mint mark. This coin is graded at an AU53. The coin grading scale goes up to 70 if you're not familiar with that. This is at a 53. This coin only sold for around $35. Now, if you were looking at the higher graded version of the coin, this coin sold for over $34,000, but it wasn't a famous collection, so that's got a lot to do with it. But the grade of the coin is going to have a huge effect on the coin prices. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I will see you on the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.